Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all doing well today. This is going to be pick a card. Two polls here. So it is who is stalking your social media today. So take what resonates, leave what doesn't. And don't forget these are energies as well. So if the King of Swords comes out, that could be female. So, you know, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. So let's get started. So we have poll one, which is Jade. And then we've got pile two, which is Amethyst. I've bloody forgot the name of that stone there. Right, I'll see you at your piles. Hey, pile one, so if you chose Jade, this is your pile of who's stalking your social media. Let's put that over there. Right, Spirit, Angels, Ancestors, who is stalking my lovely pile one's social media? Who is stalking pile one's social media, Spirit? If you hear noise and sneezing and stuff in the background, that is my dog. She's on one of them. She's been nosy. We have the Three of Pentacles. So who's stalking? Oh, blimey. Okay, I'm going to take them. Let's take them. So we have the Three of Pentacles. Just double checking that that seems short. Three of Wands. King of Pentacles. The Lovers. Queen of Wands. Three of Cups, so we've got three here. So maybe you want to check out your angel number three. From what I know from angel number three is it's a powerful manifestation number. So, you know, this is the time to manifest what you want, because it's, like I said, a very powerful number. It's like, if you're hoping for finances or a job or anything like that, this is the time to manifest it. So get manifesting, guys. So anyway, let's get back to who's stalking your social media. So we have the Three of Pentacles and Three of Wands. I'm actually getting a couple of people here. You've got quite a few people stalking your social media. Right, so for some of you, I'm seeing, like I said, there is multiple people here. I've got a funny feeling you guys are either in the media or you're on social media, so you may have a platform. So you're in the public eye. There's something that you do that is very important. You are the King of Pentacles. And like I said, this can be an energy. This can be, you know, male or female. You're a very successful business owner. You do very well for yourself financially. You know, you're financially stable. So for some of you, I feel if you have an ex-partner, they're spying on you, but also even I'm picking up more so the ones that are in a relationship, in a commitment at the moment. So it could be maybe you've just met this person and this person's, you know, being nosy to see what you're all about. But you do have someone that's interested in you that is being nosy at the moment. You have a few friends as well. So the Three of Pentacles is all about a collaboration and, you know, working together, working with people. But I do feel like it's people that you may actually work with or in the same field of business with. Then you've got the Queen of Wands. So we've got here, hang on before I move on, we've got Earth energy here, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. We've got Fire energy here, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Gemini. Yeah. So then you've got the Queen of Wands. This is someone that's very attracted to you, but this is someone that's also very attractive themselves. Very, very good looking, and very beautiful, very handsome. This is someone that's very confident, that, you know, that they could be quite loud. They say what they mean, that they say it how it is. It's someone that is just really overall comes across as being really confident. and very powerful, like they own the room, the Queen of Wands. And this is someone that's very independent. Yeah, you've got this is very weird. You've got a lot of people that has eyes on you, pile one. You know, you've got the Three of Cups here. This is a friendship card as well. So it could be a group of friends. Maybe you're not talking to them. Maybe you've moved on from this friendship group. What I'm picking up here, there's an energy here as well. It's like they're waiting for something. They're waiting for an opportunity, either with you or, you know, it could be to do with business, financial help or whatever. But they spying on your social media, wanting something from you. So they are, they're waiting and they're biding their time at the moment. Let me have a look at this. I need to clarify these cards. Clarify Three of Pentacles. Clarify the Three of Pentacles. Now we've got the World here. This is an ending. It's something that's ended or something that's coming to an end. I've got a funny feeling here, Pile One, that you've ended something with a friend group. Maybe they didn't serve you well. Maybe they just, you know, wasn't your kind of people anymore. Maybe you felt taken advantage of. Tell me about the Three of Pentacles, please, Spirit. But you are coming off as very powerful, secure within yourself, within your finances, you know. You're just confident people, Pile One. And I don't think so, Spirit. God. Right. So, I'm going to clarify the Three of Pentacles. Ace of Wands, Four of Wands, the Emperor. Right, I said here about someone's waiting for something. Someone's waiting for something to happen. I said it could either be financial help, career, you know. It can be a commitment as well because you've got the Lovers there. Here we've got someone that wants a passionate new beginning with you. We've got the Ace of Wands. And then you have the Four of Wands here. The Four of Wands is a deep commitment. It's two people that look each other as being twin flames or soulmates. It's moving in together. It's starting a life together. It's even marriage as well. We've even got the Emperor here. The Emperor is somebody's husband. You can be female. They can be female as well. It's the divine masculine. But this is someone that is very loyal, very sincere, someone that likes things organized, done a certain way. You know, the Emperor is seen as someone that is very genuine. So I do feel like whoever this is wants a passionate beginning with you, wants the marriage and the commitment, but they want it done a certain way. I think they're expecting you to do it another way, but I'm getting a feeling here you're not so sure, Pile One, because, you know, and they're waiting for this to happen. It could be maybe you've asked them to just give you time. Like I said at the beginning, that I do feel like, Pile One, that you've may have ended it with someone, or it could be that you have started seeing this someone, this special someone, and they want more from this connection. And that, I would actually say that would be more of the, you know, the way this reading is going. You have the Seven of Cups on the back of the deck. The Seven of Cups speaks of choices. You know, you have multiple choices. You have options. And it's making the right choice that benefits you or is good for you, you know. And you want to do the right thing. Let's look at the lovers. Tell me about the lovers. And it's so weird the way this King of Pentacles is actually looking towards the lovers, and hopefully you can see it, the way he's looking towards the lovers. It's like you're looking away from this. It's, and then we had the Seven of Cups, so it's like you're looking away from what's being offered here, and you're looking towards another connection, or it's making a choice about someone else. You know, it's a decision that you have to make. So it could be between two people. So your mind is not actually on this, it's on this over here at the moment, guys. Light, ring lights flickering like mad. All right, tell us about the lovers. King of Wands, yeah, we have a pair here. We have a pair, right. So the Queen of Wands can actually be seen as the other woman. We do. She can be seen as the other woman. She could be seen as the mistress. So you could have been already in a serious commitment with this person, or things were getting serious. This person wants to be serious. But your head's been turned by the Queen of Wands, King of Wands. Don't forget, these are energies. It doesn't matter. But this is a couple. This is a power couple. This is two people that when you both walk in the room, heads turn. You know, look at the way he's looking at her. And this is what's happening here. Your head is turned. You're not wanting this over here. You're wanting the Queen of Wands. You're very passionate about this Queen of Wands. You're sexually attracted to her. You know, you just find her very sexy, very beautiful. You're very handsome. You know, these two are the most handsome, pretty, gorgeous people in the tarot deck. So we have a lot of fire sign here. So yeah, this is basically what it's saying. Your head's been turned and there's a choice that needs to be made. And I do feel like this Queen of Wands is also spying on your social media as well to see whether, you know, what you're up to, whether you're still over there, whether you're choosing them. But let's have a look. Tell me about the world. Tell me about the world. What's ended here? Tell me about the world. Tell me about the world, please, Spirit. So usually when the Ace of Swords comes out, Spirit likes to say that whatever I've said in this reading is the truth. I've got it right. So that's what the Ace of Swords means. And it also means truth and clarity. It also means speaking your truth. Being truth to yourself. Truth. Oh, my goodness. Being true to yourself as well. Going for what it is that you want. I think you've tried to deny this connection because maybe you feel bad for this energy over here. But, you know, the truth is it's staring you in the face, basically. You got on the back of the deck the Eight of Wands. The Eight of Wands is on... The Eight of Wands is swift communication. So I feel like you're going to hear from this Queen of Wands. I do feel like this Queen of Wands is going to reach out to you through your social media. Tell me about the see. I wanted to know about the world, what's come to an end. And I do believe that where you will be true to yourself, you will actually put an end to what it is that's holding you back. You know, the world is all about happiness, success as well. So tell me more about the world and the Ace of Swords. Now, tell me about the world and the Ace of Swords. Oh, blimey. Three of Swords, yeah. So basically, being true to yourself is you're going to have to break someone's heart. So you're in a dilemma here, pile one, that whether you want to break this person's heart or the Queen of Wands' heart. you know, and you are slow at making a decision here, guys. You don't really want to hurt anybody. I'm not picking up bad vibes from you guys at all. I'm actually picking up that you're actually really lovely people. But you're going to have to break somebody's heart. And there is an ending of a relationship here. This is what's clarified the world here. That's an ending. This is something that's over. It's completed. So with this, it's a breakup. It's a connection that's come to an end, a relationship that's come to an end. It's also can be a third party. So I do feel like there is a third party here, but I don't feel like pile one that you've actually done anything wrong. I'm picking up more emotional cheating with you guys, not so much actual physical cheating. And spirit wants you to know as well, guys, don't let it turn toxic. Don't let it go to a stage in the within that relationship up there, or within yourself, that it ends up becoming too toxic. Also, don't let people depend on you. You know, this is a codependency card as well, guys. So it could be that you feel guilty because they're so codependent on you. You know, the King of Pentacles as well is also a father. So some of you could have children with this person up here. Yeah. So let's get some advice for you guys. So you have two people spying on your social media. You've got the person that you're involved with. You've got the person that you're interested in with. But hang on. Three of Cups. I've got a funny feeling with this Three of Cups here. It's somebody in your social circle. Someone that you're close to. Someone that you go out and you have good times with them. You know, you celebrate good times with them. But tell me more about the Three of Cups. Tell me about the Three of Cups. Yeah, look, nobody's going to win here. Whoever you choose, that other person's going to lose, no matter what. The Five of Swords is all about having to walk away and admit defeat. But it's also a facing facts of somebody is going to lose, whoever you choose. You know, and you've got the choice here. The Two of Wands is making a decision and, you know, choosing the right path for you. You know, finding that road, because you've got two roads here. And it's finding what one you want to go down, whether you want to stay, wherever you want to go. So what's your advice to pile two? What's your advice to pile two? Pile one. What is your advice to pile one? Let's get that right. If I've said that quite a bit through this reading, ignore me. Look, the Devil again. We have the Two of Cups, the Page of Wands, and the Queen of Pentacles. See, look, a couple here as well. Oh, dear. I do feel like for some of you, you're actually married to this person over here, this energy here, because this is a couple as well, guys. This is two people that are in a relationship, both in a committed relationship. But it's turned wrong. It's turned toxic. I don't feel like you're getting along anymore, the both of you. I just feel like you're arguing a lot. You know, the Queen of Pentacles, she is seen as someone that is financially stable and very humble and loyal. But sometimes there is a negative side to the Queen of Pentacles, that she can be very shallow, she can be very jealous. So So yeah, I do feel like you, this energy here, the Queen of Pentacles, is spying on you to see what you're up to maybe to get some proof that you're, you know, you're up to no good, pile one. But you've got here, you've got the Two of Cups. This is like two people coming together and finding love, finding finding commitment with someone that you've got so much in common that, you know, you feel like you're soulmates as well. And this is what I feel like you found with the Queen of Wands. And the Page of Wands here as well, it's about, you feel very passionate about this Two of Cups here, this Queen of Wands, you do. You feel very passionate about them and you're coming up with a plan to maybe be with this Queen of Wands. But Spirit also wants you to maybe plan before you jump in with the Two of Cups. Plan it, you know, do it properly. So any more advice here, Spirit? I mean, Spirit is actually saying this is a soulmate connection, you know. Any more advice for part one? Spirit wants you to know that there is happiness waiting out there for you. We've got Aquarius energy here. So, yeah, you've got happiness and abundance, you know, headed towards you. You know, all your dreams will come true. And as I said about the freeze at the beginning, this is a manifestation card as well, that you lot are very powerful when it comes to attracting what you want. So, like I said, if you're wanting this connection here, you know, you can actually manifest this. But Spirit wants you to know that this is not going to be easy for you guys when you do make your decision. And I'm sort of swaying towards the Queen of Wands here for you guys. I really am. There's not much over here that you... I'm just picking up there, you know. I know that's not very nice, but that is what I'm picking up. But Spirit wants you to know that... just be prepared that you're going to end up having a lot of baggage that's going to come with this. And the warning here as well, guys, is try not to take it into the next relationship because it's not really fair on the Queen of Wands. So, hang on, I want to get some cards here. See if there's anything relevant comes out of these before I close out your reading. What have you got? We've got pressure cooker, full of rage, ready to explode. So you've got someone around you that is ready to explode, but it could even be you that you're ready to explode because, you know, maybe you just feel so frustrated with the situation. Essential spiritual awakening, going within, empowering yourself. So you could be having a spiritual awakening right now, guys. Lost, ghosted, blocked, cut off. This... advice to you here, guys, please don't ghost this person here. Mate, this is what I'm saying, because if you do it in a way that's not done properly, it, you know, you're going to end up with a lot of baggage and a lot of burdens on your shoulder. You know, you're going to get a lot of grief. So maybe try not to ghost. Divine Masculine again, which came out up there. Archangel, protected, divine intervention. So you are protected. This is divinely guided as well, soulmates. You know, I think you are being divinely guided to this Queen of Wands here. Social media stalking, fake profiles. Yeah, I do believe there are, like I said, multiple people on your social media. Like, you've got that energy there, which is the Queen of Pentacles. You've got this new love, or this love interest here. You've got some friends here that something's happened with them, but we didn't really go much into that because there wasn't really much there. But I do feel like you've let go of some friends. Maybe it's to do with the Queen of Wands, that they didn't agree with it, or butting their nose in, and you thought, you know, sod you. Then you've got clouded judgment, not seeing things clearly, wait before making decisions. This is exactly what Spirit was trying to say. Come up with a plan before you make a decision. Don't ghost this person because, guys, you know, I mean, I know it's easier said than done, but it's really not a nice thing to do. So I'm going to leave it there, pile one, and I'll see you later. Bye. Hey, pile two, if you chose Amethyst, this is your reading. So let's get started. So Spirit, Angels, Ancestor, who is spying on my pile two? Who is spying on my pile two social media? So we've got the Seven of Pentacles, King of Pentacles, a lot of Pentacles, King of Cups, Four of Swords, and the Nine of Cups. Are we in shock? I hope so. And on the back of the deck, we've got the Ten of Swords. So, two energies here. King of Pentacles and the King of Cups. So we've got a water sign here. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, and an earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn here. I mean, it can even be the same energy, but I don't think it is. I think it is two people that are actually spying on your social media. Whoever this energy is, or these two energies here are, they feel really betrayed by you. They feel like you stabbed them in the back. It's like something you did, pile two. You know, we'll look into it, but it's like you planted seeds. I think you planted seeds of doubt, or you manipulated a situation, hoping to get the outcome that it is that you want. So you didn't really care, pile two, on who you sacrificed. But like I said, you can actually reverse this as well. So it could be that this is what this person did to you. So if that doesn't resonate, that it wasn't you, just turn it around, guys. So, but I'm picking up that, you know, pile two, this, you know, you may have actually done this. Right. Now, the King of Pentacles is someone that is very, very successful. They have their own business. They are married. They can be married. Usually are married. They usually father, mother. But this is someone that owns their own business and is doing very, very well with themselves. You know, quite well off. Then you've got the King of Cups. Someone that can play games, you know, sometimes they feel like, I'm picking up, okay. I'm picking up same-sex relationship here as well, guys. You know, not for all of you, but for, you know, part of the reading, I am picking up same-sex here. So I am... bit weird. So, didn't even ask. The Lovers, yeah, look. No, the Tower, sorry. I've got a funny feeling here, guys, that some of you decided to move on with somebody else. Like I said, for some of you, if it's same sex, you know. But they're all energies here. But I'm picking up that you moved on with somebody else. That's why the portrayal was on the back of the deck. Now you've got... You know, the truth came out and everything was turned upside down and it caused a lot of problems. It caused a lot of arguments. You know, your life was pretty... Or their life was a big mess. Tell me about the King of Pentacles and the King of Cups. Tell me about the King of Pentacles and the King of Cups. tell me about the King of Pentacles and the King of Cups, please. Bit. Oh. Queen of Cups. Yeah, basically what I said. You were already in a relationship with somebody, so now you've got, you left this Queen of Cups. Yep, turn your back on this person, Three of Wands. You left this person, this Queen of Cups, for somebody else. Either it was the King of Pentacles or the King of Cups. The King of Cups is somebody that's deeply in love, you know, very loyal, very sincere, you know. And I do feel like there's deep love between this King of Pentacles and this King of Cups here. And, you know, we can't help who we fall in love with, can we? But who got affected in this when the truth came out was the Queen of Cups. Now, the Queen of Cups is really pissed off. So she's actually, I think she is the one that is spying on your social media at the moment, guys. So, you know, the planted of the seeds and this, that, the other, I do feel like you manipulate the situation, pile one, to get with your King of Cups or to get with your King of Pentacles. So you've had to be a bit sneaky. And, you know, this Queen of Cups feels very, very betrayed, because don't forget, the King and Queen of Cups are a couple. They're a pair. So when the truth came out, the Queen of Cups, she obviously saw red. Let's find out a bit more about the Queen of Cups. Hang on. Tell me more about the Queen of Cups. I've got a funny feeling here, guys, that what's happened is this Queen of Cups has literally gone online and just literally posted it all over social media and put your dirty laundry on for the world to see. That's what I'm picking up on. Yeah, look at this. Look at this. The Lovers. You made a choice. You chose somebody else. I mean, and if it is a same-sex partnership, maybe this was a shock to the Queen of Cups. You know, take that for whoever's watching this, that you know, if that resonates for you. But like I said, these are energies, so you know, it doesn't matter. So yeah, I do feel like the Queen of Cups, because she can be seen as very, very spiteful when, you know, seen in a not so nice light. She can be seen as someone that is very insecure. She can be very needy and quite sulky, quite possessive as well. And maybe you just felt like it just was, you know, I mean, who wants to be in a relationship like that anyway? But I'm picking up spiteful energy from this Queen of Cups. I do believe she got so spiteful because you made a choice and you moved on with somebody else. So we have Gemini here as well, guys. And what's happened is you're in the Four of Swords. These two energies here, you're both in a Four of Swords because of all the crap that's come with this Queen of Cups. She's literally let the cat out of the bag. She's literally told all your secrets to everybody that you know. And now you're in this energy of, you're just emotionally drained. Now the Nine of Cups, why are you there? Why are you there? Tell me about the Nine of Cups. But just be a bit careful, Pile 2, because I do believe that, I don't think this Queen of Cups is actually done with you guys yet, because the Seven of Pentacles is about plotting. So I'm going to clarify the Seven of Pentacles in a moment. I want the Nine of Cups first, please, Spirit. Tell me about the Nine of Cups. Thank you. Tell me about the Eight of Wands. Eight of Wands is swift moving energy. It's also messages that come out. Now, the Emperor again. Yeah, look. Right. Losing my voice. So, the Nine of Cups, you see this relationship here with the King of Pentacles and King of Cups as your wish fulfillment. You know, it's everything that you've wanted in a partner. You know, and you feel like your wish came true as well. So what I'm seeing here is the Emperor is the divine masculine here, but don't forget you can be female as well. And this is someone that is very loyal, that's wants a commitment, that, you know, wants to commit to you. You know, this could be someone that wants to get married, can be someone's husband, but I'm not picking up on that yet. It's someone that is, you know, plans things and sees things through. So I do believe that you both plan this together. I do feel like these two energies here are both the Emperor, you know, because you're in love, basically. I'm picking up that you're both in love. We've got the Lovers here. And you made a decision straight away, you know, to obviously move forward together, to be together. So things happen quite quickly for both of you. You know, this relationship with you both is an equal give and take relationship. It's totally equal. There's no one way or the other way, or someone does more. And that's not what I'm seeing. It's both of you giving and receiving equally. You know, the Emperor wants to look after their partner. Tell us about this Queen of Cups. Tell us more about this Queen of Cups. What should we expect from the Queen of Cups? What should we expect from the Queen of Cups? I mean, it's a very weird reading. It was supposed to be with spying on social media. It still is. I do feel like, you know, is the Queen of Cups that is spying on your social media, but I do feel like you lot have been plastered all over social media. This is what I'm getting. Tell us more about the Queen of Cups. What is she up to next, Spirit? What is the Queen of Cups up to next? Oh, no. Oh my god, I don't think so. Tell us about the Queen of Cups. Oh, wow. That's so many cards. It'll be a whole bloody day. All right, I'm taking them. Let's just take them, see what the Queen of Cups is up to. We've got the Chariot, the Devil, Nine of Wands, Eight of Swords, Ace of Cups, Queen of Swords, Five of Pentacles, the High Priestess. Wow. Okay, there was a reason why all these came out. So, and your little warning here, guys, is that this Queen of Cups is on the move. She is literally there, like, for some of you, this person could be following you in their car. So maybe look, if you're out and about, maybe look out for their car. I'm picking up that they're actually following you. This, like I said about the Queen of Cups, she can be very, very toxic, very spiteful, and very clingy as well. So yeah, I do feel like this person may be following you around in their car, but there's forward movement here. There's something coming towards you guys, something that's not so great. The Devil is all about toxic energy, toxic behaviors. It's someone that is addicted to something, and I feel like they're addicted to you. They can't let you go. It's like this codependency. It's this connection that they don't want to let go. They feel like you're theirs. They feel like they own you. I'm getting quite fiery about this. But yeah, just overall toxic. You know, the Queen of Cups is working at a lower vibration to you. You know, you've got two people that are actually in love here, but she's at a very low vibration. So I do feel like she's going to carry on spreading crap about you guys. So maybe you want to lock down your social medias quite tight. Because she's walking around, I'm saying she, it can be he as well, guys. She's walking around like the wounded warrior, like you've done her some kind of injustice. Yes, maybe you did. But there's no excuse for this kind of behaviour. So because they feel like the wounded warrior at the moment, and their mental health is suffering a bit, I do feel like this person's addicted to some kind of happy stuff as well. I'm just going to say happy stuff because it's YouTube. Don't want to get like flagged. But yeah, so they feel wounded. They've got this chip on their shoulder at the moment because of what happened. You've got the Eight of Swords. They're in, mental health. It's the worst card in the tarot deck, the Eight of Swords. This is someone that is very depressed, feeling very low. Their mental health is at an all-time low. They could have a mental illness as well, but I'm not a doctor. I'm just saying. But this would explain the devil here. So yeah, they're not. That sounds really bad. Also, they're not all there. That's not the right word. They're not in the right frame of mind at the moment. So just be careful, guys. We've got the Ace of Cups here. Now, the Queen of Swords, Aquarius, Gemini, Libra. Queen of Swords hates the fact that you've got a second chance at love. Hates that fact that you were given this opportunity to find love and not with her. So, the Queen of Swords, which is the Queen of Cups, same energy here, because the Queen of Swords is someone that's been deeply hurt, that was in a relationship. You know, it's someone that's in separation. It can be someone that's going through a divorce at the moment. And the Queen of Swords can be very malicious and nasty and cruel, but very obsessive as well. And this is what I do believe, she's become so obsessed with both of you that this is not in an obsessed with the fact that you both get this love and she doesn't. And she's going to do something. She's going to do something. I don't know what she's going to do, though. I'll ask Spirit in a minute. Yeah, look, Five of Pentacles. She feels like you left her out in the cold, which most probably you did. You may have turned your back on this person because, obviously, if she's acting like this, you know, you don't want to be around that. That's not healthy. This person could be going through an illness. Like I said, you know, I'm not a doctor, but just feeling not very well within themselves. And this is someone that's maybe struggling financially as well at the moment. You know, maybe you were the breadwinner. You, like I said, the King of Pentacles is the breadwinner, is the one that has all the, you know, the money and that. And maybe they don't like the fact that you took that away from them. Now we've got the High Priestess. Spirit wants you to use your intuition here, guys. Don't ignore your intuition. If it's telling you something, please listen to it. I do believe you guys are quite psychic yourselves. You've got this inner knowing about you. You know, you're quite special. Things are going to be revealed to you. What is it? But I feel like you already know. I do feel like when you see this reading, you're going to see what I'm saying, but you're already going to be sitting there saying to yourself, I already knew that was coming. That's what I mean about the High Priestess and you not being psychic yourselves or have that intuition, that gut feeling, you know. And don't ignore it. Tell us about the High Priestess. Eight of Cups, yeah. Tell us about the High Priestess. Yep, you've walked away. You're walking away from this person fully. I do believe you've tried to be nice. You've tried to help this person, but because of their instability and their behaviour, you are going to literally cut all ties with this person. I feel like you are actually done. Tell me more about the High Priestess. Yeah, look, Three of Wands, you're going to turn your back on this person. They're waiting for you to, you know, maybe come back, but you're done. You're walking away. And this is justice, you know. You tried to be fair. You tried to do things fairly when it came to this Queen of Wands, Queen of Swords and Queen of Cups. But, you know, this is Libra energy as well. You had to do what was best for you and you have to do what's best for her as well. And I am saying her, guys, like I said, keep repeating, it's like a bloody parrot. Can be male as well. But yeah, you had to do what was best for you and them. And the Queen of Wands. You know, because you're passionate about this energy up here. You're very passionate about them. You love them. Look, on the back of the deck, Ace of Wands, passionate new beginning. you love them inside and out, very attracted to them. You're very loyal and committed. You know, the Emperor's there as well. So you'll want this new passionate beginning, but I do feel like you're feeling quite drained when it comes to this energy down here with the Queen of Cups, because they're putting a downer on it. But like I said, you did something a bit sneaky, you know, you may have done things to get what you wanted. And I don't feel it was out of maliciousness or anything like that, but I do feel like this Queen of Cups is doing things out of pure maliciousness to get back at you. And I'm going to get a couple of cards from here before I close the reading, guys. So tell us a bit more. Any advice? Any advice? Thank you. Clouded judgment. Not seeing things clearly. Wait before making decisions. But I don't feel like... I feel like their judgment is clouded, but maybe Spirit is telling you as well just to be a bit careful. Maybe you might lose your temper with this energy here. You may overreact. So Spirit wants you to just take a step back and not like make rash decisions. Entrapment. Feeling trapped by pregnancy, money, heartstrings. Right, here we go. Thank you, Spirit. Exactly what I said. I'm not seeing pregnancy here at all, guys. For some of you it may be, but I'm not seeing pregnancy here. You're feeling trapped by money. I do feel like, because I said this person feels like you left them out in the cold, that they're going through poverty at the moment. Maybe you've withdrawn money from them because of their behavior, and this person's manipulating you by pulling on your heartstrings. Hence the devil energy there as well, guys. So a little bit more, please, Spirit. Part two. Blood ties in a circle. Giddy, happy, overjoyed, excited, anticipating something. Causing chaos. Oh wow. Suffering a loss. Give yourself time before proceeding. Wow. So basically, for some of you, you can have children with this person. You can have, or it could be that this person's still in your inner circle that knows your family, or in a friend, like your circle of friends, and it's becoming quite hard that maybe you two are feeling excluded from this, you know, maybe people judging you because of what this Queen of Cups is saying. This is why they're overjoyed and giddy, and they're anticipating something. This is what I'm saying, that they're up to no good. There's something more coming from this Queen of Wands. Queen of Cups. And it's giving them I think they get a high out of this. And I do feel like you do actually really miss this person, or the person they used to be. But I do also feel like it's the actual Queen of Cups that is mourning the loss of you. But, you know, Spirit is saying give yourself time, but this person ain't giving themselves time. They're not mourning properly. Drama Queen, causing chaos. Hang on, I can't leave it like that, guys. I know it's turning into a long reading, but hang on. Spirit, what does this Queen of Cups plan on doing to my pile twos? What are they planning? Two of Wands, Four of Wands, Ten of Wands, Strength, Knight of Wands. Yeah, they're going to try and come between you and your partner here. They can see you're moving forward. Two of Wands is moving forward, you know, going down a different road to them. This is what you're doing. You're in a serious commitment with this King of Cups here. You are in love. You know, you could have moved in together, or you're planning on moving in together. It could be that you're planning on getting married and settling down with one another. And they're not happy about this. This is causing them, this is causing them to stress about this. They're constantly thinking about this, and I feel like they're constantly thinking of ways to destroy this connection that you've got here. You know, they're coming up with they need strength to follow through with this. And the Knight of Wands is someone that is a player or someone that likes to seduce. So just be careful. This is what I think they're actually going to do here. Yeah, I do really believe that this person is going to either make up lies that they've done something with you sexually, or are they going to start spreading around that, you know, you're a player, you're a cheat, because the Knight of Wands is someone that's seen as a player energy, a cheat, you know, they can be a cheater. Their energy is in and out, they're not stable, they're not faithful, they like to mess around. And this is what I do feel like is going to come out here, guys. So you're being warned here. The Divine Spirit tells us what it was. So this could be what is going to be plastered all over your social media. They could be telling everyone on your social media or their social media and tag unit, what have you, that you may have both slept together, or that you are sleeping around, basically. But this is a load of bullshit, which you already know this, but you know, you're being warned now. So I'm going to leave it there, my pole twos, and you take care, and I'll see you soon. Bye.